Mataji. Let's start the meditation of the new day by collectively surrendering to the lotus feet of the Devi. Collective Namaskar, Kundalini. Faisons un Namaskar collectif, ce jour nouveau au pied de notre mère. Namaskar collectif et montons la Kundalini.
Or do this kind of a disco, you will be saved. So now you behaved and went out of the Sahaja Yoga. 10 Sahaja Yogis went away with him. They are not attached to me, but to that stupid Sahaja Yogi. He went to. He came back and they went away with him. That shows you have not developed your personality. How dare anybody influence you and say that get out of Sahaja? If you have a mature personality and responsibility, you will say, I have to do Sahaja Yoga work, that's the main thing I have to do. You must know that though you look ordinary people, but God has chosen you. If any one of you do not do Sahaja Yoga work, who will be blamed? In every aspect of life, one should understand. You see, I don't say that you give me money or anything, I don't want anything from you. As it is, you know how much I am spending. But definitely if money is needed somewhere, you must go all out to help with money also. People will spend money in, say, races or spend money on some sort of a pub. All that money is saved now. You don't have to go to a pub, nothing. So if money is needed, you have to spend. Then another thing is people just start asking, why so expensive, why this, why that? In Sahaja Yoga, everybody knows accounts, everybody has accounts. There's nothing secret. Where money goes, what we are using for, how do you have this tent? How do you have this land? How do you have Dolly? Just think, nobody thinks like that from where mother gets money. To do all these things. I don't need such a big castle, do I? For what? I've already bought another house in London from my own money. Why? There's already, we have spent so much money for this shooting camp. It's giving no money at all. Why? I don't need Sahaja Yoga, it is you people who need. And if you start saving money on that also, then I don't know what to say to you. It doesn't mean like in the church they say you must give money and all that, but your dedication. If you have the dedication, then you will yourself think that is my responsibility. On the contrary, you'll say, oh, you need money, all right. Now school has to be built. Who has built Vashi? Who has built this Ganpatipure? Who has built such a big ashram now you'll see in Delhi? Who has donated money for Sahaja Yoga so far? You all have prospered in life. You all have got sufficient money. But what are you doing? So, in this aspect, you have to see that you do your level best for Sahaja Yoga. Another side is your creativity. There have been very great artists who came out of Sahaja Yoga. If they have to give any present, they'll give the smallest possible, the cheapest possible. The most expensive one, they keep with themselves and sell it. If they could give even one piece like that, we can sell it in the market, just for Sahaja Yoga. But they'll give something very cheapish, which cannot be used. It's just adding up to my personal archives. But if they give something sensible, it can be so. Then musicians who go abroad they can give some, their programs and things can make some money. And also, if it is needed, that money can be used. Do you know, I just asked once that collect some money for India project. 1 year in Sahastra. I must know that there were only £5,000 collected. And I was so ashamed that they are still there as it is in the bank. How can I send 5,000 to India? What will they think of you? Even the school for you, it is for your children, not for Indian children. But still it will be built by Indians, I know that, or by me. Thus, we should realize that if we are wasting some money somewhere, we can utilize some money for Sahayoga, we should have some money for our organization. Otherwise, this is how whatever we save on food or anything, that's very little amount. But still, we are managing. Every guru takes money outside first and then come to the puja. Outside. And that too, for real sumptuous one. I don't need any money. Even your puja money, everything you know, it goes into silver. Because you cannot have puja with plastics. So, to understand this, you have to have auspiciousness, holiness. Now, you call me Holy Mother, but are you respectful like that? Do you know what I am? Ganesha knew. Once his father said that whosoever goes round the Mother Earth first, I'll give that person a present. So, another brother, Kartikeya, he had a nice vahana, a nice vehicle, was a peacock. While Ganesha had just a little rat, a mouse, he could never have competed with him. So he said, who is greater than my mother? She is the greatest of all. What is this Mother Earth or anyone? She can create so many Mother Earths like that. So she just went round her and he got the prize. And this Kartikeya was still flying. So that is what it is, to understand the auspiciousness. I mean, though I must say I am a Mahamaya, no doubt, it's not easy. You will never know me fully, never. That should not be, because then you won't sit here, you'll run away. But despite that, try to understand. As Ganesha has understood his mother, you have to understand. That extent is rather difficult, but still try. That this is the power sitting before. How we behave, how we talk, how we take decisions, what we do is all wrong. If this doesn't penetrate into your brains, that means Kundalini has not come there. People could not raise even one kundalini, one person's kundalini. Even this artist who came, she said, how can it be possible? I am not I've done nothing. I'm not a person who is a saint. How can I get realization? She was telling me like this. How can it be, Mother? But you all got it, no doubt. None of you have doubts about it. And not only that it's happening through me, but you also can do it now. Who can do this kind of a thing in the history of spirituality? But I keep a kind of a image of myself. I joke, I make fun, I do everything just like a normal mother. But that should not give you liberties. That should not. Some people have written very rude letters to me, I must tell you. Be careful. You can't write rude letters to me. Better not. When you suffer, then you will say, Mother, this has happened, that has happened. You have no business to write rude letters to me. And though I read them, and I forgave, no doubt, because you are ignorant. But you must have knowledge. You must understand this, that whom are you writing and what you are writing. This side is, of course, we have to see that Sri Ganesha has also a Parasha in his hand. He is one of the most strict deity, very strict. Others may a little bit hesitate, but he cannot tolerate. That's why Christ has said that I will tolerate anything against me, but nothing against the Holy Ghost. Clearly he has warned. Clearly. Because he has a parasha in his hand. And people get punished, no doubt. So this is another thing one has to understand, that Sri Ganesha has this parasha. And you too all have this parasha in your hand, which you don't know. Anybody who will try to trouble you will be in trouble. But what is missing is the faith. Not blind, but enlightened faith. If you have enlightened faith, then it works. There's one gentleman working in London airport. He's an Indian, but I think he was looked after by some Western foreigner people. Very good man. So he cannot come to programs, he's very busy and all that, he cannot. But if I am at the airport, he knows I am there. Some people try to trouble him. So he said that, don't trouble me, my mother is very strong, you know, and don't trouble me. They won't listen. Three of them. And three of them next day lost their jobs. They said, why? He said, we don't know. The boss told us, you get out of jobs. We don't know how we lost our jobs. And they still today they haven't got jobs. He said, I told you. He said, what, who is your mother? Let us meet her also. You see, this is what has happened to us. Sorry. But nothing works out now. So you must have full faith in Sahaja Yoga, in me, and in yourself. Those who do not have faith in themselves, how can they have faith in others? This is another one thing you must understand, that you have tremendous powers. Tremendous powers, if you have faith. You just pray. Mother, I want this gentleman to be cured, or this lady to be cured. It will be cured. You don't have to even touch that person. But your faith. Like yesterday, they brought one lady. I was very busy, I was talking, doing this. These are the only 2-3 days when I have to really work very hard with all the problems. And I couldn't see her. I said, why don't you go and cure? You can cure. Why should any Sahaja Yogi suffer from anything when there are other Sahaja Yogis? Why should I cure anymore? You all just put your hands and see if you can cure or not. Even your prayers are so powerful, you have no idea. Just pray. You have got the parasha in your hand, nobody can harm. And you have got the hand that can bless others. You have got that. You start your generosity and see, the Lakshmi will flow. But if you are not generous, calculating each and every pie, finished. Why should you? The Lakshmi will serve you. Know your powers. As Sri Ganesha knew it very well. He never bothered. Even with an elephant head, he managed so many things. With human heads, you should manage much better. But you need elephant heads. Then another thing he has, that he is a satisfied person, extremely satisfied. And what he eats is the modaka they have given me just now here, is the modaka he eats. So, that means that he eats something which is substantial, which has got all these dry fruits and everything in it, that's what he eats. And that is one capacity he has, to eat because you can please him by giving him things. But mine is just the other way around. I can't eat much and you want to give me. I don't know, he has taken all my capacity to eat, I think. But he can eat well. And whatever you eat, if you think of him, Sri Ganesha, I offer you this food also. You'll never find dearth of food at all. Never. Anything you want, like the other day it was very hot. They said, Mother, cool it down. I said, all right. As soon as I cooled it down, left to the right, Sri Ganesha comes up. So he came with full force. He cooled it down and rained and rained and rained, brought water also, because there was no water in these streams. You had to do your foot soaking, so water came also. And what a testing, it in one thing, how much happened. He tested you, he saw you, nothing happened. Even a little tent was not blown off. It was all fun. This is what is that you are also a testing ground for others. Immediately you will know what sort of a man is. You are so powerful. Use your powers. But what happens if your attention is on other things? It's not pure. Attention is on other. Keep attention on Sri Ganesh. Keep attention on me. Everything will work out. Why should you work when he is there to work out everything for you? His ganas are there to work out for you. So put your attention in such a way that you know you are alert, daksha. You are alert, you know where is your attention. And then you see the attention, how it works. I never expected that I'll mature you so fast, but you have matured. But unless until you know yourself fully what you have got, how am I to give you certificate? Even if I give certificate, you won't believe. Like they say, you are graduated. Now you are not only graduated, but you are masters. Otherwise, I would never have told you to ask for Gurupada. You are Praveenas now. Praveen means a master. Use your mastery. But still you are sitting at home, this, that. My father is sick. Go and treat him. You are a master. Like Sri Ganesha, such a little thing like that is the master. You are also masters. The ladies also should know they are also masters. Instead of getting involved into smaller things and brickbats and all that, rice. The another great quality of him is that he uses his teeth to write. Teeth come to you from Shri Krishna. Wisdom of Shri Krishna, which becomes the Virat, the brain. So he uses the teeth to write. He wrote Mahabharata with his teeth. So it is said that you must use your brain with the enlightenment of Shri Krishna and write and produce it into books. All these gurus have been successful because they created books. And these books were read by people and they were so much impressed, because anything black and white becomes something great. You can also make nice dramas as you had made. You can approach the televisions and things that we have a nice drama for children. Now think about going into people. Live with the society, live with them. Deliver to them what you have got. It is your duty. Is not only that, but it is also, it's a special privilege to you. I mean, for today, as it is, we had to delay, and I've tried to give you some points about Sri Ganesh. I think even if you give me 100 lectures, I cannot finish it. It's so great. It's like an ocean to me. So I hope you'll understand the essential, fundamental principles of Sri Ganesha. And what is innocence is? First is wisdom. May God bless you.
Sakshan Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Let's sit comfortably from the four corners of the world where all the children of the Devi are in meditation collectively with one heart, one kundalini, one attention, one collective virat body, enlightened body, one attention, and one devotion, one true sincere devotion at the lotus feet of the Devi. Let's put both our hands on the floor and say four times Sri Ganesh mantra from our collective heart, where Sri Shiva himself resides and shines. Mettons les deux mains sur le sol et disons quatre fois le mantra de Sri Ganesha à partir du cœur au niveau collectif. Om Tvameva Saksha Shri Ganesha Saksha Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Ganesha Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Shri Adi Bhumi Devi, four times, with full attention on Mother Earth, and to awaken the connection, the collective connection with Mother Earth. Let's realize that we are all over the world and all putting our hands from all over the world on Mother Earth and all calling upon her from our collective heart. Let's have that global consciousness of the collectivity, connecting and awakening the power of Sri Adi Bhumi Devi. Disons quatre fois le mantra de Sri Adi Bhumi Devi, en gardant toujours les mains sur le sol et l'attention collective autour de la terre. Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha Om Tvameva Sakshat Shri Adi Bhumi Devi Sakshat Shri Adi Shakti Mataji Shri Nirmala Devi Namo Namaha. Let collectively, as one being, surrender to our mother, Shri Adi Bhumi Devi, and also to Shri Ganesh, who is completely the master of the magnetism in Mother Earth. Total surrender. And let collectively also open our heart and send out all our love, express our love from the heart to Mother Earth and to Shri Ganesh in Mother Earth. Promettons-nous collectivement à Shri Ganesh dans la Terre Mère et à notre Mère, la Terre, à partir du cœur. En gardant les deux mains sur le sol. be more collective in our attention, have an attention which is very high above Sahasrara, united with the attention of the divine, while still keeping both hands on the floor. Let's really surrender, truly surrender to Mother Earth, and feel that Mother Earth is absorbing all the lethargy, negativity, sadness, traumas, all the past, collectively, individually, everything that is bothering us within, from the left side, all the attacks, all the possessions, everything that is adharmic in our left side, collectively, individually, we just surrender it to Mother Earth. All the negativities of our ego, of our superego, collectively, individually, all the imbalances in left side, at the collective level, at the individual level, but also at humanity level, we surrender it to Mother Earth. Similarly, we do the same for the right side. All the negativities of the ego, all the imbalances of the right side, all the reactions, all the mind, all the actions, everything that is creating a dharma in our right side, in our actions, we surrender to Mother Earth. And lastly, we also surrender everything that is preventing the central channel to be pure, all our chakra to be cleansed, with our muladhara on the floor and both our hands on the floor, we surrender the central channel, all the central channel, which is completely infinite and which is wide, wider than all of us, wider than the creation. We surrender the central channel to Mother Earth. Completely, all the negativities of central channel that are preventing us to be witness, pure instrument of the divine, pure light wherever we are, each of us, pure powerful child of the Devi. Total surrender of left channel, right channel, and central channel to Sri Ganesh and to Mother Earth. let's also surrender all the heaviness in our heart, everything that is preventing our heart to be pure, completely pure, so that the Devi herself can be in our heart, so that our heart is comfortable for her, for Sri Shiva, for our mother, for the Lord Ganesh, to establish the pure joy in our heart. Let's surrender all negativities, darkness, reactions, bad thoughts, or bad, everything that is adharma in the way to express our heart. Let's surrender to Mother Earth. With true sincerity and collective attention. Le genou. Right hand still remains on the floor. Complete attention still on the Lord Ganesh.
Sri Ganesh Atharva Shirsham. Om Namaste Ganapataye. Tvameva pratyaksham tatvamasi, tvameva kevalam kartasi, tvameva kevalam dhartasi, tvameva kevalam hartasi, tvameva sarvam khalvidam brahmasi, tvam sakshadatmasi nityam, ritam vachmi, satyam vachmi, avatvam mam, avavaktaram, avashrotaram, अवदातारम अवधातारम अवानुचा नमवशिष्यम अवपश्चात्तात अवपुरस्तात अवोत्तरात्तात अवदक्षिणात्तात अवचोर्ध्वात्तात अवाधरात्तात सर्वतो मां पाहि पाहि समन्तात् त्वं वाङ्मयस्त्वं चिन्मयः त्वमानन्दमयस्त्वं ब्रह्ममयः त्वं सच्चिदानन्दाद्वितीयोऽसि त्वं प्रत्यक्षं ब्रह्मासि त्वं ज्ञानमयो विज्ञानमयोऽसि सर्वं जगदिदं त्वत्तो जायते सर्वं जगदिदं त्वत्तस्तिष्ठति सर्वं जगदिदं त्वयि लयमिष्यति सर्वं जगदिदं त्वयि प्रत्येति त्वं भूमिरापो नलो नीलो नभः त्वं चत्वारि वाक्पदानि त्वं गुणत्रयातीतः त्वं देहत्रयातीतः त्वं कालत्रयातीतः त्वं मूलाधारस्थितोऽसि नित्यं त्वं शक्तित्रयात्मकः त्वां योगिनो ध्यायन्ति नित्यं त्वं ब्रह्मा त्वं विष्णुस्त्वं रुद्रस्त्वं इन्द्रस्त्वं अग्निस्त्वं वायुस्त्वं सूर्यस्त्वं चन्द्रमास्त्वं ब्रह्मभूर्भुवस्वरोम् गणादिं पूर्वमुच्चार्य वर्णादिं तदनन्तरम् अनुस्वारपरतरः अर्धेन्दुलसितं तारेण रुद्धम् एतत्तवमनुस्वरूपं गकारपूर्वरूपम् अकारो मध्यमरूपम् अनुस्वारश्चान्त्यरूपम् बिन्दुरुत्तररूपम् नादसन्धानम् संहितासन्धिः सैषा गणेशविद्या गणकऋषिः निचृद्गायत्री छन्दः गणपतिर्देवता ॐ गं गणपतये नमः एकदन्ताय विद्महे वक्रतुण्डाय धीमहि तन्नो दन्ती प्रचोदयात् एकदन्तं चतुर्हस्तं पाशमङ्कुशधारिणं रदञ्च वरदं हस्तैर्बिभ्राणं मूषकध्वजं रक्तं लम्बोदरं शूर्पकर्णकं रक्तवाससं रक्तगन्धानुलिप्ताङ्गं रक्तपुष्पैः सुपूजितं भक्तानुकम्पिनं देवं जगत्कारणमच्युतम् आविर्भूतं च सृष्ट्यादौ प्रकृते पुरुषात्परम् एवं ध्यायति यो नित्यं स योगी योगिनां वरः नमो व्रातपतये नमो गणपतये नमः प्रमथपतये नमस्तेऽस्तु लम्बोदरायैकदन्ताय विघ्ननाशिने शिवसुताय श्रीवरदमूर्तये नमो नमः साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः
Now, let's open both hands. Complete surrender to the Lord Ganesh. Complete surrender of all our chakras, all our being.
Shri Ganesh ke 108 naam. ॐ श्री विनायकाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री विघ्नराजाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री गौरी पुत्राय नमो नमः। ओम श्री गणेश्वराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री स्कंदाग्रजाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अव्ययाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री पूताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री दक्षाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अध्यक्षाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री द्विजप्रियाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अग्निगर्भाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री इंद्रश्री प्रदाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री वाणी प्रदाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री सर्वसिद्धि प्रदाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शर्वतनयाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शर्वरी प्रियाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री सर्वात्मकाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री सृष्टिकर्त्रे नमो नमः। ओम श्री दिव्याय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अनेकार्चिताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शिवाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शुद्धाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शुद्ध बुद्धि प्रियाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शांताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री ब्रह्मचारिणे नमो नमः। ओम श्री गजाननाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री द्वैमातुराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री मुनिस्तुताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री भक्त विघ्न विनाशकाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री एकदंताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री चतुर्बाहवे नमो नमः। ओम श्री चतुराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शक्ति संयुक्ताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री लंबोदराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शूर्पकर्णाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री हरये नमो नमः। ओम श्री ब्रह्मविदुत्तमाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री कालाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री ग्रहपतये नमो नमः। ओम श्री कामिने नमो नमः। ओम श्री सोमसूर्याग्निलोचनाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री पाशांकुशधराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री छंदाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री गुणातीताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री निरंजनाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अकल्मषाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री स्वयं सिद्धाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री सिद्धार्चित पदाम्बुजाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री बीजपूर फलासक्ताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री वरदाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री शाश्वताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री कृतिने नमो नमः। ओम श्री वीतभयाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री गदिने नमो नमः। ओम श्री चक्रिणे नमो नमः। ओम श्री इक्षुचापधृताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री श्रीदायकाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री अजाय नमो नमः। ओम श्री उत्पलकराय नमो नमः। ओम श्री श्रीपतये नमो नमः। ओम श्री स्तुतिहर्षिताय नमो नमः। ओम श्री कुलाद्रिभेत्रे नमो नमः, ओम श्री जटिलाय नमो नमः, ओम कलिकल्मषनाशकाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री चंद्रचूडामणये नमो नमः, ओम श्री कांताय नमो नमः, ओम पापहारिणे नमो नमः, ओम श्री समाहिताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री आश्रिताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री श्रीकराय नमो नमः, ओम श्री सौम्याय नमो नमः, ओम श्री भक्तवांछितदायकाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री कैवल्यसुखदाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री सच्चिदानंद विग्रहाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री ज्ञानिने नमो नमः, ओम श्री दयायुताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री दान्ताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री ब्रह्मद्वेषविवर्जिताय नमो नमः, ओम प्रमत्तदैत्यभयदाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री श्रीकंठाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री विबुधेश्वराय नमो नमः, ओम श्री रामार्चिताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री विधात्रे नमो नमः, ओम श्री नागराज यज्ञोपवीतिने नमो नमः, ओम श्री स्थूलकंठाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री स्वयंकर्त्रे नमो नमः, ओम श्री सामघोषप्रियाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री परस्मै नमो नमः, ओम श्री स्थूलतुंडाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री अग्रजाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री धीराय नमो नमः, ओम श्री वागीशाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री सिद्धिदायकाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री दूर्वाबिल्वप्रियाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री अव्यक्तमूर्तये नमो नमः, ओम श्री अद्भुतमूर्तिमते नमो नमः, ओम श्री शैलेन्द्रतनुजोत्संगखेलनोत्सुकमानसाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री स्वलावण्यसुधासारजितमन्मथविग्रहाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री समस्तजगदाधाराय नमो नमः, ओम श्री मायिने नमो नमः, ओम श्री मूषकवाहनाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री हृष्टाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री तुष्टाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री प्रसन्नात्मने नमो नमः, ओम श्री सर्वसिद्धिप्रदायकाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री मूलाधारचक्रसंस्थिताय नमो नमः, ओम श्री अबोधिताप्रदायकाय नमो नमः, ओम श्री गणनायकाय नमो नमः, साक्षात् श्री आदिशक्ति माताजी श्री निर्मला देव्यै नमो नमः।
silent meditation, where we are totally one at the lotus feet of the Lord Ganesh. Let collectively unite ourselves to the Lord Ganesh so that he can be in all our chakras, in our heart, in all our cells, collectively, individually. We become collectively united with the cosmic form of the Lord Ganesh. Let's feel the presence of the Lord Ganesh within his vibration. In all our chakras, in our heart, the joy in our heart, the purity, the vibration, the light, the love. Complete surrender to the Lord Ganesh collectively. In this collective state of unity, let's surrender all the obstacles at any level in our lives, collectively, individually, and also at humanity level, at the level also of the collective of all the yogis of the world. Complete surrender of all the obstacles and to all the powers of the Lord Ganesh, so that we can be protected, complete protection, complete surrender to the Lord Ganesh to benefit from all this power, innocence, protection, removing of all obstacles, auspiciousity, and all these powers. Collective Namaskar, Kundalini. With a heart full of gratitude and thanking Sri Ganesh and our mother again and again.